So, guten Morgen. Darf ich Sie alle bitten, Platz zu nehmen? Can I all ask you to take a seat? I'm happy to welcome you. My name is Peter Brook. I'm privileged to help run the research studios Austria Forschungsgesellschaft and together with the rector of the University of Mozarteum, Elisabeth Gutjahr, we are hosting this international research networking conference on interactive music technology. Thank you, Mrs. Gutjahr, that you are here and that you will also introduce this conference. The basic idea of the conference is to network research which is already being done, to look at how research and what research agendas people have all around Europe and how this can be connected to what is happening here in Salzburg at the University of Mozarteum and also at the Research Studios Austria. The idea is that a very highly reputable organization, institution of academic learning and artistic training and education like the University of Mozarteum, together with a high technology research and translational research organization like the Research Studios, cooperate in order to network and to produce most innovative research in Austria, in Europe, and around the world. As you may know, the brand of Mozarteum is strong from China to Japan and from Canada to Argentina. The Research Studios are an organization which is a distributed organization. It's hopefully also an agile and lean organization. There is about 40-45 researchers from the Research Studios here. And I say hello to each and every one of you, especially those who for the first time are here in St. Gilgen, because as we are growing and as we are changing, we have also new staff, especially also new staff in terms of also the leading of the Research Studios. I say especially welcome to Peter Knoth, who is for the first time here as a studio director of data science. Our areas of research is data science, is pervasive computing, it's smart application technologies, but also very strongly in the area of mobile, social microlearning, distributed and user-generated microlearning. That's something where we have also a number of spin-offs and spin-off companies. We work with companies there. And then, especially here in Salzburg, our focus in cooperation with the University of Salzburg in the geoinformatics area with smart settlement systems as our largest and most successful research studio, and also smart 4D environments, which works in the area of all the range of IoT, in the range all the way to how to groom, set up, and also work well with spatial data infrastructures. This is what we do, and our cooperation as a translational research organization is with a number of institutes. You will hear very shortly one of the stars which we have in our organization. It's Alois Ferscher, who is also the head of the Institute of Pervasive Computing at the Johannes Kepler University in Linz, but he is also the managing director of a large Austria leading organization, COMET Center, in terms of translation of smart cognitive systems in the area of the production of the future, and he will tell you a little bit more about that shortly. We are working here in this various cooperation, and especially with the University of Mozarteum in the four first listed research studios. What is the idea in behind the research studios? It is an agile process. It's a process orientation. It is an orientation of chains of projects which lead from basic research to very much applied research, and where we then always look also not just of the output, but also on the impact. And our relationship with startup companies is, I think, one of our hallmarks of success and distinction. Our conference has a number of objectives. It's very much focused in terms of being collaborative, to be supportive, and also to connect on the level of the top researchers in Europe, and therefore I say a special hello to everyone who comes from the outside to this. And we want to have an outcome of this conference. It's not that we're here for just for talking, but we are here for action, and our action can be measured in the terms of the number of projects which will come from these interactions. It is important that in the presentations, each and every one of you who I will then just welcome very much personally in a short order, specify also what you're working on, how you're working on it, and also what are your future plans for the coming years, and what is your expected impact and the scalability. There's a number of roadmaps in terms of what music technologists do. Some of you here in this room have worked on this roadmap. I can see that Michele Magas is here, who has coordinated this project from the Music Technology Group. This is from 2012, and you can see here the range of different kind of topics and also agendas which will be presented today by a number of people who have worked in this consortium, especially also from the University of Pompeu Fabra in Barcelona. What is interesting here, and when you look at this image, which I want to thank also Benedict Golan for, he is the author of many of the images which I use here, is that what we are talking about here today and what we will talk about in the next years is not the old way of looking at computer science, informatics, musicology, ethnographic research. The old way is to look at it as separate disciplines. The new way is to see that what we are doing in the area of aware systems, what we are doing in the area of data analytics, what we are doing in terms of smart recommendation technologies, that this is not just transdisciplinary, but it is transformative of those disciplines. And that is the interesting part. And I know that many of you in your presentations will address this, and that is something which is very much welcome and important. We start with Alois Ferscher, and he will talk about the work which we are doing in the research studio Pervasive Computing Applications, and he will have, an introductory presentation of this. The real advantage with Alois Ferscher is he will never stop. So the question is, how do we all get Alois Ferscher to not talk for 2 hours and 17 minutes, but for 40 minutes? He told me he wants to have 45 minutes because he has such good videos. So we'll live with that. Right, Alois?
Yeah, I
refer
to this as
Mission Impossible, okay. But then we have Sergi Jordio here, and he will talk about a number of things in terms of electronic music performance. And here, what is interesting to me is especially the interaction aspect. My mantra is what makes digital interesting is interaction. Okay? Buy it or not, but this is the mantra on which we build, we work, and if you look at what I do outside of the research studios, you know my interest is in interaction. It is how, what is it, what we can do when we start to have matter speak back to us and matter transformed from us. And that is what is so unique about the 21st and 22nd century. We will then have a short video from Stefania Serafin from Aarhus University. You will see how she is setting up her lab, and she's talking about that work, and I think that's a very good transition to what Helmi Fendt will talk about. She has done an incredible work over the last 30 years and built up an oeuvre, a whole repository of work in terms of what she is doing with music performance. And also, she traverses everything from what I would call ethnomusicology studies in terms of participatory research paradigms in the direction of open access debates and dialogues in the area of music. I thought I'd give you an impression of what this view looks like in the summer. And when you have lunch, you can imagine that. And also putting on your bathing suit and jumping into the water here. But if you don't want to jump into the water, then you jump back into music technology. And I'm very happy that last minute, Michaela Magas was happy to come. And she will talk about what she has done as transformative work in terms of Music Tech Fest and the technology transfer kit and other things. I think that she is a good partner to Alois Ferscher in never stopping to talk.
Right.
Yes. Okay, you will have a competition. then we will have Peter Knoth. He comes to us from the Open University in Britain, and at the Open University, at the Knowledge Media Institute, he has worked on the big scientific data analytics group, and he will give an introduction to information retrieval. I don't want to hide from you my prejudice against music information retrieval. I think it's not the most fertile, but we will then see right away after this by Peter Knees, whom I say hello. He is the person who is at the Technical University of Vienna, now the focal person to do this creatively. And I talked to Andy Rauber just a couple of days ago, and he said, this is the right guy to talk in Austria about this, especially if Gerhard Widmer wants to stay in Linz. Then we have Tilman Weide. Tilman is in the network also of the MIRES, and my interest is to hear from him and to hear there what he's working now on in the next years, and I think that's something very, very important. And then we will have an input from Maria. Where's Maria? Maria? Hi, Maria. And she will have a video as well as she will have a spot input, and she is also fighting for more time to speak. That's right, Maria? Yes. Okay, so then we will have Hauke Egermann, and I'm very happy that he is coming here also to bring the perspective of the psychological dimensions, the experience dimension, the aesthetic dimensions, and so on, and especially also of how to interact with music in an innovative and new way. And I'm sure that the research which he's doing is, I think, most interesting and experience-oriented. Benedikt Gollan has said that he is gonna map all of this, and he needs only 15 minutes for the mapping. I guess it's... Is it really? Or is it 20? Okay, good. So then we will see what the mapping is. And if you want to see, we have put some of his stuff already in posters outside. And that's what he's doing. At the end, we will talk, have a fishbowl, and basically to that all the people can interact here. And then we will see how this works. And then I think we have something which is really most interesting in terms of seeing how what digital can do in terms of supporting most excellent research in the world, and that is coming from Sandra Vengadasalam, who is the division manager at the Max Planck Digital Labs in Munich. And I'm most interested in hearing what it is actually the outcome and the acceptance, Sandra, of the Bloxburg project using blockchain technology as innovative services for academia. At the end, we will then look at the road ahead and see how we can do this. And I hope that we can do a lot of networking later on in the evening with the dinner and following the conference. So a big thank you to you all. And I ask Elisabeth Gutia to give us the inspiration now for the day. Elisabeth, bitte.
Yes, thank you very much for this warm welcome. And I'm happy to be here to follow the conference. Of course, old ship like the Mozarteum is quite slow. slowly on the way to future. But in the inner structure, the students, the teachers, the researchers, we find a lot of wild energy, which needs to have contact cooperation partners to develop in direction digitization, in direction innovation, and combine really high knowledge from old techniques with a high knowledge of today techniques in digitization. So that's our interest here, and a very wide range, sometimes focused on very precise questions, sometimes more in a kind of general thinking. How should we think about future? How should we think, or shall we think, to improve our today life, our working with resources, but also our thinking about our own self-understanding, our identity as being human and talented with artistic possibilities. So we are persuaded that the methods and the way how artists are working is something so special and so precious that it should be involved in logical, technical, even practical thinking, and that this connection is still not really established. The separation, as you talk at the beginning, the separation between the disciplines, between the different area of research and excellent working is no longer helpful really to develop kind of holy concept of what future should be and what human beings should be. So we try to open the door and to meet other disciplines, experts, researchers from other disciplines to come into a discussion and to try to find out how can we manage to bring this different expertise together. So that's a little bit our question here. So I'm very happy to be here and very open. If someone wants to question me or contact me, please feel welcome. And thank you for this possibility to work here.
Thank you very much, Elisabeth Kutia.